Hey there, are you ready for a dose of superhero action? Then you're in the right place. In today's video, we're going to be diving deep into one of the most highly anticipated games of the year, Suicide Squad: Kill the Justice League. Developed by Rocksteady Studios, the creators behind the highly acclaimed Batman: Arkham series, this game has been a long time in the making and fans of the superhero genre have been eagerly anticipating its release. The game was initially set to release in late 2022, but it was delayed, and now it's finally coming on May 26, 2023. In this video, we'll be covering everything you need to know about the game, from the story and characters to the gameplay and trailers. We'll also be discussing some of the latest updates and the reason behind the delay. So, sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. First things first, let's talk about the story of the game. The game is set in the same universe as the Batman Arkham series, and as the trailers have revealed, the story revolves around Amanda Waller recruiting a team of anti-heroes from prison, Deadshot, Captain Boomerang, Harley Quinn, and King Shark, and forcing them to do her bidding if they want to avoid being killed by bugs planted in their necks at any moment. The squad struggles to work together as a team will be a big part of the story arc, and we can expect to see a lot of character development as they navigate their way through the game. The main villain of the game is Brainiac, who has somehow managed to infect or control the members of the Justice League, leading to the Suicide Squad being forced to take them down. We'll see appearances from popular Justice League members such as The Flash, Superman, Wonder Woman, Green Lantern, and Batman, which is sure to make for some epic battles. Moving on to the gameplay, it's been said that this game will build on the foundation laid by the Batman Arkham games, but with some key differences. For one, players will be controlling a team of four characters, each with their own abilities and move sets. The game is set to feature open-world gameplay, allowing players to explore a version of Metropolis, which serves as the DC Universe's capital city. This open-world environment will also allow for a variety of side missions and activities that players can take on, in addition to the main story missions. As we dive deeper into the world of Suicide Squad: Kill the Justice League, don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. By subscribing, you'll never miss an update on this game and many other interesting games that we cover. Plus, it helps support our channel and helps us continue to bring you high-quality content. So, hit that subscribe button now and join the rest of our community of dedicated gamers and fans. Now, let's talk about the trailers. We've already seen a few different trailers for the game, each giving us a little more insight into what to expect. The first teaser trailer was released in August 2020. It gave us a sense of the tone that Rocksteady is going for with the game. It showcased the characters and some of the quirky, funny moments we can expect.
We lost the target! Repeat! Task Force X has lost the target!
Damn it! Argus 3 is taking heavy fire! Get to Park Ridge ASAP!
Don't worry, boss. We got this.
Then, in October 2021, we got a more in-engine trailer that showed us more of the story and the villains we'll be facing. In December 2021, we got an actual gameplay trailer that gave us a glimpse of how each of the four characters will control and what kind of epic battles we can expect. Finally, at the Game Awards in 2022, we saw a touching trailer featuring Batman, one of the squad's targets, and confirming that Kevin Conroy's voice performance as Bruce Wayne will be one of his final ones.
I am vengeance. I am the night. I am Batman.
This trailer gave us a bit more information about the story and showed us more of the iconic characters we'll be interacting with. It looks like we can expect some epic showdowns with the Justice League as we try to save the world from Brainiac's control. The game has been delayed for a reason. Rocksteady Studios is an experienced developer, and they want to make sure that Suicide Squad: Kill the Justice League is the best it can be. The game will be a next-gen experience, so it'll only be available on PlayStation 5, Xbox Series X/S, and PC. That means you'll need one of these newer consoles or a gaming PC to play it. The delay was necessary to take advantage of the newer hardware and to make sure the game is running smoothly on these platforms, so that players can experience the game to the fullest. In conclusion, this game is shaping up to be an exciting and thrilling game, with an engaging story, epic battles, and open-world gameplay. It's sure to be a hit with fans of the superhero genre. The characters, the setting, the graphics, all looks fantastic. We can't wait to get our hands on it and play as the Suicide Squad taking down the Justice League. Remember to leave your thoughts in the comment section below and make sure to check out my playlist for updates on other interesting games. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this and turn on the notification bell so you never miss a video. Thanks for watching!